This course is dedicated to block modeling. In course 3A, we saw the general definition of the notion of equivalence. We will measure here the structural equivalence in order to classify nodes of graphs by block modeling. We will see that one can use also the regular equivalence as well, and we will see a famous example using regular equivalence on world cities. So starting with the measure of structural equivalence, the overall principle of the method is to start from a social matrix, as the example here, with the corresponding graph. Thus, thanks to a permutation of rows and columns, here, one can associate nodes sending or receiving similarly to other nodes. Matrices classifying position by blocks of similar networking are useful ways to summarize some kinds of ties between positions. One builds an image matrix about multi-relational network between positions B1, B2, B3, rather than information about individual actors, and then we obtain a reduced graph between the different positions. This approach was introduced in the 80s in sociology. Note that geographers also used permutation of rows and columns like Bertin in 1967, who used it in order to classify the 80 Parisian quarters and their socio-economic population compositions. So he started from the list of the 80 quarters and their population with the old class of socio-economic population, and he permuted the different rows and the different columns in order to obtain the final classification of the quarters. But multivariate analyses were then adopted by many geographers in the 70s to solve the classification issues. So geographers mostly abandoned this approach. Rather, in sociology, using mainly dichotomous relation with 0 and 1, they focused more and on this kind of approach. For example, Bird introduced in 1976 the Euclidean distance to measure structural equivalence between two nodes, I and G. It depends to their own relation with every k nodes of the graph, making the sum of the two directions. So we have the difference between ik, jk, but also ki and kj. The maximum possible value corresponds to the total opposition between nodes I and j relations. The minimum occurs when they are structurally equivalent. Other authors proposed a form of Pearson correlation between nodes relation. This index standardized all the calculation by the mean value in row and columns. So each time it is the value minus the mean of row and columns and standardized by the total. So it is a form very similar to the Pearson correlation. And this index can be done for one kind of relation, so with one network, or several kinds of relation for multiple networks. Using these correlations, White et al. developed the procedure named CONCOR for convergence of iterated correlations. It is a repeated iterative correlation between rows and columns of previous correlations. Results of only correlation of plus one or minus one, except on some unusual circumstances. And according to these proximities, one can start the partition.